Hello, 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 all you scrappers out there. So, let's see what kind of scrap we're going to find in the dumpsters today. And right away, we have some aluminum and some other bits and pieces in here, along with some wing stock. They have some pretty good wings though too, so yeah, I think garlic parmesan's pretty good. As you can see, Mr. Volt is already collecting all his scrap.
Find a bolt, pick it up. All day long, you have good luck. Look, I just found these two water heaters next to the dumpster. Their brand is Bradford White. They have an exhaust fan system, like integrated. And each one is about $2,600. And the weight is 170 pounds each. They're pretty heavy. I hope you're having a wonderful day.
So there you go, full load of 700 pounds. And those water heaters, they added a good amount of weight. And yes, that was Mr. Volt, so he's going to be joining us a little bit more. And on our members, if you guys are members, we're going to be doing member videos. And Mr. Volt will be doing more shorts and member videos as well. The pile, the huge, huge pile of stainless steel. Volt is ready to unload. So, Boone mentioned this before, when you do heavy metal steel, we do get about $10 for every 100 pounds. So it's nice when we get like a full load of heavy metal steel. When it's mixed, it kind of like varies. You know, we get a little bit less for tin and other types of steel. Have the trash checks in there too. So I love seeing all the different types of metal, you know, machines and everything that they have in there. 49 dollars. There you go. 70% tin, 30% heavy metal steel. And that's for a 700-pound weight. And of course, you guys already know that we donate 10% of all of our scrap money to St. Jude's Children's Research Hospital. Okay, these right here, well, this one, there's only one, but yeah, we found this before. Mr. Volt has shown it, and as you can see right here, it retails for $615 from Mercedes, and that's like the partition door, and we have found one before. Mr. Volt has sold it for, I believe they paid $300 for it, and that's just, you know, found, you know, free. And yeah, that's something that, you know, we love to find. So the last time we found one, it did sell pretty quick, and they got a good deal, we got some extra money. I'm not sure, you know, why they just leave them out like that. You know, the one we found before, we did see that, you know, they did switch it out. So, yeah, that'd be nice if it's like a regular thing, so hopefully we find some more later. Mr. Volt is getting the trailer ready to load up the partition door. We've seen some other ones too that are like even more expensive. There's some that are over $1,000. Even some, you know, that are close to $2,000. And these ones are just brand new, taken out. You know, maybe they, you know what? I think what it was that we noticed last time was that Mr. Volt had said that they had switched out for the ones that have a door where you can walk, you know, in between. So it looks like they just get rid of the partition that it comes with and then they kind of like upgrade it. So either way, you know, that's a good find for some scrapping and reselling. So of course, if you guys are scrappers, you know, check the stuff that you find, because if you take this in for scrap, I mean, you're not going to get that much for it. Something like this, I mean, it has a little bit of weight to it, but if it's something like this that you know it's going to sell, then put that in and, you know, list it, sell it, and you can get a lot more money for it than just taking it to the scrapyard. And someone else can use it and get a good deal on it too. So, win-win. And yes, make sure to use your heavy-duty straps. For lighter things, you know, you can use the bungees. But when it comes to, like, bulkier things, then we do recommend using the straps. There are different types as well, too, for, like, different weights. And that goes, you know, that goes for bungees as well. So you need to check on that. Make sure that your bungees or your straps are strong enough, you know, to hold the load that you're carrying. And especially the bungees, if you leave them out in the sun, they start to break down too. So just be careful with that. Yes, we will take a dirty fan. Looks like someone dropped their flag, so we will take that. Some insulated copper wire and bottles. So we do take cans and bottles. Our kids, they'll sort those out and they'll get the money for that. So, you know, if Mr. Volt's already there and he can grab it, then that's fine, but usually he's not gonna just, you know, go in and dig around for like a can or bottle. It does put a lot of pressure on his stomach and his body to jump in and out. So yeah, he tries to get the cans and bottles when he's able to just grab them like that. Just, you might want to skip the pee bottles. We find so many pee bottles too. Yeah, don't take those. Those are dirty. Steel. And of course, always be careful for sharp objects. Don't just start digging in everywhere and you don't know if there's a blade or something inside. And yes, we do have some curtain rods in there, so if you guys are not familiar, we did, you know, find a huge score of curtain rods, but there were some that were dented or damaged, And those went for scrap, so you can still scrap some stuff. Which is a good thing, you know, you're not just gonna throw it away, so you can scrap it, recycle. I like the shapes on those things. Like, I don't know if you guys have ever done any projects with scrap. Let us know in the comments. Sophie and I were watching Iron Giant. And if you guys are not familiar with that movie, you know, it's a cartoon movie. But yeah, there's a scrapper. And he comes out because he hears some noises. And then he starts saying like, oh, you know, I thought you were gonna steal my scrap. And then he's saying, you know, everybody wants to steal the scrap, but when he makes like his sculptures and stuff, like he can't give them away. Nobody wants them. But we've seen like these really cool sculptures and stuff made from scrap. So I was like looking at some of these pieces in here, and they have like some good shape to them, like designs and stuff. I don't know. I'm just like looking at the scrap and seeing like what else can be made from this. We have some pieces for the gardens, and yeah, it's just, it's interesting, you know, like how people can make new things from even scrap and all kinds of stuff. You know, we've seen stuff where they've made things from bottle caps, denim, jeans, all kinds of stuff. It's very creative. And it's nice when these companies just leave the stuff out, like they leave the scrap for pickup. So we love that. I mean, because look at all of this in one pile versus having to, you know, take it out from several dumpsters. So thank you for that. And yeah, a lot of these places, they're, you know, they're fine with Mr. Bolt scrapping. So that's why, you know, he's able to just park it right there and load up. But of course, if he sees, you know, he's in the way, then he'll move it. So when we do like retail dives, that's, I think, one of the differences, you know, is that for scrapping, he's able to, you know, pull up and load up everything because the businesses are fine with him scrapping. But with retail, I'm driving the car, so once I see, you know, that there's delivery trucks coming or whatever, you know, if they're blocking something, then I move the car right away. We find so many fans and heaters. So like now that it's getting colder over here, people are wanting the heaters. So yeah, we have, you know, heaters that we've collected. Later it's gonna be fans. And some more aluminum. And even with aluminum, there's like different categories, different types of aluminum. So all of these pieces right here, they fit perfectly in the trailer. So Mr. Bolt is able to take all of this stuff. He is gonna leave a big piece, but he lets another scrapper know. So there's other scrappers that, you know, when they find something that they don't take, they'll let Mr. Bolt know, and then sometimes, like, when he finds something, he'll let them know. Okay, this thing right here, this is really big. So yeah, we can take all of this, but we're not going to take that big old piece right there. But even with that, that's a good amount. Gotta make it more compact. For one stop. Mr. Bolt's gonna check his load right there. Gotcha! Yes, so this is when you need a big truck to take some of this stuff. But also be careful too, we have seen trucks where they've put like loads and it has crushed the back of the door, you know, that goes up. So yeah, just be careful. Even if you have a truck, just watch out with your scrap that you pick up, because you don't want to just damage it, you know, just for a piece of scrap. So a few little goodies in here. And unfortunately, the radio that you see on the side, that one was broken. Make sure to like this video, subscribe, and of course, have a great day. Bye.